related to the topics we have done till today. That worksheet was related to exercise 2.1 and question number 1 of exercise 2.2. Okay, so today I'll be giving you solutions of the questions which were in the worksheet. Fine. So let us start with question number 1. What was the question number 1? Which is the smallest natural number? Children, do you know what are natural numbers? We have already discussed about natural numbers. Natural numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to so on. Okay, so from where these natural numbers are getting started? These are getting started from 1. So which one will be the smallest natural number? Yes, can anybody tell me which one is the smallest natural number? By looking at this collection, you can get to know very easily which one is the smallest natural number. 1, because natural numbers are getting started from 1. So 1 is the smallest natural number. Okay, is it clear to all? So this was the solution of question number 1. Let's come to second question. What was our second question in that worksheet? Which is the smallest whole number? In first question, we have written smallest natural number. And in this question, we have to write smallest whole numbers. So children, as you all know, when we add 0 to the collection of natural numbers, then it becomes the collection of whole numbers. So from where does the whole number start? Whole number starts from 0. Yes? So which one will be the smallest whole number? Yes, can you tell me which one is the smallest whole number? 0. 0 is the smallest whole number because the collection of whole numbers starts from 0. Fine? So this was the solution of question number 2. Let's come to question number 3, children. Fill in the blanks. A part is dash multiplied by 13 is equal to 13 multiplied by 18. These type of questions you may have done earlier also. See, if you have 5 multiplied by 7, then that will be equal to 7 multiplied by 5. Because 5 sevens are 35 and 7 fives are is also 35. So dash multiplied by 13 is equal to 13 multiplied by 18. So what will come here? 18 will come here. It means whether you multiply 18 by 13 or you multiply 13 by 18, the answer will remain same. And the children, which property is this? This is the... Yes, we have done this property, na? A multiplied by B is equal to B multiplied by A. Which property is this? This is commutative property of multiplication. Yes, we have done in the properties of whole numbers, na? This is commutativity of whole numbers. Fine. Now, let's come to B part. Whole numbers are closed under dash and dash. Children, I have explained you that whole numbers are not closed under division and subtraction. But the whole numbers are closed under, yes, whole numbers are closed under addition and multiplication. So its answer will be addition and multiplication. Okay, next C part is dash is the identity for multiplication. Children, I have explained the identity for addition and multiplication. What is the meaning of identity? Identity means here we are finding multiplicative identity. So it means if we are multiplying any whole number by any number, we should get the same answer. So by which number we should multiply this A so that we get I again? So that we get A again. Yes, we will multiply this by 1. So 1 is a multiplicative identity. It means whenever we multiply any whole number by 1, we get the same number. So that means this 1 is the identity for multiplication. D part, if dash is added to a number, the sum will remain same. Okay, so again we are here talking about the identity. Yes, so which number should be added to any whole number so that the sum will remain same? Yes, what is the answer of this question? If dash is added to a number, the sum will remain same. Can anybody tell me? Can you all guess? Yes, the answer will be additive identity 0. Or here we will just write 0. If 0 is added to the number, the sum will remain same. If you are adding 7 and 0, the answer will be 7 itself. So if we add 0 to a number, the sum will remain same. Hence dash, hence 0 is called the additive identity in whole numbers. Additive identity in whole numbers. Is it clear to all? Okay children, so this was the solution of question number 3. Next is fourth question. How many whole numbers are there between 12 and 86? Children, this kind of question we have done in our exercise also. You have to tell the whole numbers between 32 and 53. So how we had done there? We had subtracted this 32 from 53. 3 minus 2 is 1. 5 minus 3 is 2. 21 has come. Then we have subtracted 1 from this 21. 21 minus 1 will be 20. So there will be 20 whole numbers between 32 and 53. But here we have to find out the whole numbers between 12 and 86. So what we will do? We will subtract this 12 from 86. 6 minus 2 is 4, 8 minus 1 is 7. Now what we have to do, like this only, we have to subtract 1 from 74. So that will be 73. So it means there are 73 whole numbers between 12 and 86. Okay. So now let's come to question number 5. Fifth question is, find the successor and predecessor of each of the following whole numbers. Now we have to find out the successor and predecessor. First part is 999. So here we have to find out the successor first. So children, what is the meaning of successor? Successor means the number which comes just after the given number. It means we have to add 1 to this. 999 plus 1 will be equal to, yes, you can add 1 here. 9 plus 1, 10. 9 plus 1, 10. And again 9 plus 1, 10. So this is 1000. Yes. After that we have to find out predecessor. Predecessor means the number which comes just before the given number. Before means we have to subtract 1 from this. So 999 minus 1 will be equal to 998. Okay. Now let's come to second part. Again we have to find out the successor here. So we will add 1 to this 21,999. If we will add 1 to this, then it will become 9 plus 1, 10, 9 plus 1, 10, again 9 plus 1, 10, 1 plus 1, 2, and this will be 2, 22,000. And for finding the predecessor, we have to subtract 1, 9 minus 1, 8, 9, 9, 1, 2. So predecessor of this will be 21,998. Now let's come to third part. For finding the successor, we have to subtract 1, 1 minus 1, 0, 0, 0, 4, 4,000. And predecessor will be the number which comes before. So we have to subtract 1 here. Children, sorry, here we have to find out successor. So we have to add 1. Na? So 4001 plus 1 will be 4, 1 plus 2. 1 plus 1, 2. So that will be 4002. But in predecessor, we have to subtract. So predecessor of 4001 will be when we will subtract 1 from 4001. So that will be equal to 4000. Fine. Successor means the number which comes just after, and predecessor means the number which comes just before the given number. Fine. Next, fourth is, here for finding the successor, we are going to add 1 to this. So that will be 2 plus 1, 3, 1, 0, 0, 0, 5. And for finding the predecessor, we have to subtract 1. 2 minus 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 5. Fine. Now let's come to fifth part. Successor will be when we will add 1 to this. 2, 1, 1, 1, 1. And predecessor will be when we will subtract 1. 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. Fine. So this is the solution of question number 5. Now let's move to next question. Next, we have to start with sixth question. Sixth is, what is the predecessor of 1 lakh? 1 lakh. Children, how do we write 1 lakh? 1 and then how many zeros? In lakh, there are 5 zeros. So we will write 5 zeros after 1. Now we have to find out the predecessor of this 1 lakh. Predecessor means the number which comes just before the given number. It means we have to subtract 1 from this. 10 minus 1, 9. 9, 9, 9, 9. So, children, listen. This was a 6-digit number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, this is the smallest 6-digit number. Then we have to find out the predecessor of smallest 6-digit number, then that will become 99,999, which is a greatest 5-digit number. This we have done in chapter 1 also. Okay, so the predecessor of 1 lakh will be when we will subtract 1 from this 1 lakh. So that will be equal to a greatest 5-digit number. A greatest 5-digit number means 99,999. Okay, so this is the solution of question number 6. In 7th question, we have to write the next 3 natural numbers after 34,099. Here we have given the number 34,099. 1s, 10s, 100, 1000, 10,000. So it's 34,099. Okay, so children, we have to find out the next 3 natural numbers. And in your exercise also, I have explained this kind of question for finding the next three natural numbers. What do? We add, firstly we will add 1 to this number. 9 plus 1, 10. 9 plus 1, 10. 1 plus 0, 1, 4, 3. So this will be our first natural number. After this, then we have to add 1 to 34,100. So that will be equal to 34,101. Then we have to add 1 to 34,101 also. That will be 34,102. Okay. So what are the next three natural numbers after this number? Next three natural numbers will be 34,100, 34,101 and 34,102. We have added 1 to this, then we have added 1 to this, then we have added 1 to this. Okay, that is how we will get the next three natural numbers after 34,099. Clear? So this was the solution of question number 7. Eighth question is, write the three whole numbers occurring before 40,021. Okay, here we have given this number 40,021. Here we have to find out the three whole numbers occurring before this number. So what are we going to do for finding the numbers which is before that? What do? We subtract 1. So for finding the number which comes before this, we will subtract 1. 1 minus 1, 0, 2, 0, 0, 4. Then we will subtract 1 from 40,020. 10 minus 1, 9. This will become 1. And then we will subtract 1 from 40,019. So that will be 40,018. So the numbers which comes before 40,021 will be 40,018, 40,019, 40,020. Okay. So these are the three whole numbers that occurs before 40,021. We just have to subtract 1 from 40,021 first, then 40,020, and then we have to subtract 1 from 40,019. Okay, so this is the solution of question number 8. Next, ninth question is, in each of the following pairs of numbers, which number is on the left of the other on the number line? Okay, we have done these kind of question also in the exercise. A part is 892 and 356. So children, as we have already discussed, the number which is smaller, that will come on left hand side of the greater number. So firstly we have to find out which number is the smaller one. 356 and 892, which one is smaller? 356 is smaller, so 356 will come on left side. Left of 892. Because the smaller number always come on left side of the greater number. Now let's come to B part. B part is 607 and 670. Which one is the smaller number here? See, if it is smaller, then we have to put the sign here. Okay? Because this is the greater one, na? So, in this number 607 and 670, which one is the smaller number? 607 is the smaller, so it means 670 is the greater one. So which 607 will come on left of 670. Okay, because 607 is smaller than 670. Okay children, so this is the solution of question number 9. Next and the last question is, find the sum by suitable rearrangement. So these kind of questions were there in exercise 2.2, that was question number 1. So what we have to do in this, we have to arrange the numbers in the groups so that we can get more and more zeros. So children, we have to form the groups here first. See, if we add 3 to this 7, we will get 10, it means we have got 1 zero. But if we add 5 to 0, then what we will get? We will get 5 and 1 carry was also there, so we will get 6. So it means we are not getting more zeros here. So let us check this 7. This 7 plus 3 is 10, means 1 carry. 5 plus 4 is 9, 9 plus 1 is 10. It means again we are getting a 0. So we will add this and this first. 953 plus 647 plus 407. We have to make the groups such that we can make more and more zeros. We can get more and more zeros. So 3 plus 7 is 10. 5 plus 1 6. 6 plus 4 is again 10. 9 plus 1 10. 10 plus 6 16. 1600 plus 407. Now we can add it. 0 plus 7 is 7. 0 plus 0 is 0. 6 plus 4 is 10. 1 plus 1 is 2. So our answer will be 2007. You can add it like this also. 0 plus 7, 7. 0 plus 0, 0. 6 plus 4, 10. And 1 plus 1, 2. So the answer will be 2007. So children, today I have given you the solutions of the worksheets which I have given you to solve. So you just have to cross check your answers whether you have done the questions correctly or not. If by mistake you have done the questions wrong, then you can make them correct by looking the video. Okay, and that's all for today children. Tomorrow we are going to start with the question number 3 of exercise 2.2. Fine. Okay, so have a great day. All the best. God bless you all. Thank you so much.